Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to The Last of Us Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. Where we last left off in Chapter Number 2, The Quarantine Zone, Marlene here, the head of the Firefly's Rebellion Group, was telling us she has some precious cargo we need to deliver, so let's follow her and find out what she's all about.
We gotta get out of here. Now. You want this deal? We gotta move.
Oh, I want the deal, all right. I want the deal of a lifetime. Howie Mandel, welcome back to Deal or No Deal. Do you want the zombie-infected corpse behind briefcase number one? Or do you want to switch it out with the one over there that our model is holding? Oh, you've opted for the zombie-infected corpse and you're infected. Whatever happened to Deal or No Deal? That show was, like, huge for, like, 3 weeks. And then after that, you know, Howie stopped hosting it and it basically just disintegrated. It's a weird thing with game shows these days. Ever since the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire craze in like early 2000-2001. Ooh, wow, this is kind of nice. Got a nice view of the city of Boston here. Oh, and they just blew it up.
Holy shit. Is that your people?
No.
What's left of them? Why do you think I'm turning to you guys? This way.
Zagan Bridge over there, that's still intact. Good thing the zombies didn't destroy that.
Yeah. We've been quiet. Been planning on leaving the city, but they need a scapegoat. They've been trying to rile us up.
Looks like they did.
We're trying to defend ourselves.
I know this is really depressing and everything, but to get back to my game show, thing I was saying, as I collect all these sweet parts, duct tape, scissors, parts for stuff. After the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire came out, a lot of game shows, well, they were all flashes in the pan. They would come in, you'd have like, remember Minute to Win It? That was huge for like a month. And then nobody watched it anymore, and I don't even know if it's on. I think it got canceled. And then now there's a whole bunch of other shows that seem to come and go, but the game shows seem to happen the quickest, and they happen in quick bursts. They'll have like one episode every night for a week, and then they'll get taken off the air and you'll never see them again. Well, they'll get put into syndication, which is basically the same thing. I'm just going to explore back here. Thanks, everybody. All right, Marlene, where are we going? Where's this cargo that we were supposed to transport for you?
Hold up. Soldiers. That's the way out. The door under the bridge.
Roger that.
I ain't a big fan of these odds.
We can sneak by.
Never tell me the odds!
I know that's not your style.
We'll see how it goes. Let's get moving.
Yeah. We're moving, all right. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun.
We need to get to that door.
Yep, thanks for the prompt to let me know what I was already looking at.
Big Steel Company Warehouse.
I'll get this one.
Just this way for no one, Private.
And whatever.
Ah, shit. How am I supposed to get rid of that schmuck? There's another guy right next to him. He's looking right at me. Oh, I can go in and I can go this way. Okay. Also, I can pick up a brick. This is why I call these amnesia runs. Because it's not a blind run, because I've played before. But I forget a lot of stuff, too, so... Yep!
You got me, okay?
It's okay. It's okay, go to sleep now, go to sleep now. Stay quiet.
Alright, what do we got in here? Hey, I said, what do we have in here?
Oh, right, okay. We're on a stealth mission.
Watch yourselves.
Picking up a lot of sweet duct tape. I haven't done anything with this stuff yet, but here we go, I can create a shiv, combine the duct tape with the scissors, and you can build stuff. It's called crafting. It happens in real time, which means if you take time out to craft something, you are vulnerable to attacks. Really cool game mechanic that I suspect many future games will be borrowing.
But props to Naughty Dog for coming up with that really cool mechanism in the game that, you know, you have to repair yourself and create your own weapons, but at your own expense and at your own risk. You have to collect the supplies, which means you have to go out of your way to find them and to scavenge and to explore the area and go off the beaten trail. And you also have to take time out in the middle of a firefight, say, to repair yourself or to create more Molotov cocktails or more health kits, like this one right here. So I'm a big, big fan of that. I think it was a really smart move on their part to create such a mechanism, and it's really, really fun. And it creates a lot of additional difficulty and drama, even in this, the easy mode difficulty I'm playing on. So we're gonna let this guy get out of the way here. And then we're gonna strangle his friend. He's oblivious, completely oblivious. All right, Tess, you could help out here. You could have just got that other guy. I realize you don't want to.
Keep it up.
But I'll do all the work, no problem. Oh, that's it. Oh, that's it. Just let it happen. Just let it happen. Oh. All right. All right, now let's run over this way. There was a guy he was looking at. I think he already executed him. I don't think there was any way I could have saved these guys. Old Firefly friends of yours? You gonna teabag him? All right, fine. I guess they weren't your friends. Anything's back this way? It's a negatory. Oh shit, you see that guy? Right under the sign there for Waterline Street number 33. That's my lucky number. But it's not your lucky day. All right, he sees the corpse.
What's that?
Ah, jeez, I fucked that up. Pressed the wrong button. It's okay, though. Can I just push him right off the edge of this? I've never done that before.
Not much further now.
All right, fine. What do we got here, a bottle? It's just a bottle. You can't drink out of the bottles. You can only throw to distract and to stun enemies. Take a moment to take in the scenery here, which, extremely impressive for the seventh generation of consoles. PlayStation 3 is, as you know by now, on its way out, and The Last of Us is certainly one of the last great titles for this generation of consoles. Certainly the absolute last great exclusive title. I would say the only big title left for this generation would be Grand Theft Auto 5, but that's not exclusive.
This way.
Watch Dogs. I'm really looking forward to that title. I don't know if you can count it as a seventh generation title because it's being simultaneously released on both generations.
But I'm running on fumes.
Those are my two big games I'm looking forward to coming up. Kind of been ignoring the in-game dialogue here because it's like, oh, I'm tired. It's up ahead. Here we go. This way.
Attention. Curfew is now in full effect. Anyone caught outside without proper authorization will be arrested and prosecuted.
Alright, good to know. I just won't let myself get caught. We get this boat on the road already?
John, boats don't go on roads, they go on water. You bojo! Those boats don't work on water! Unless you've got power!
We just came up that stairway, didn't we? Jeez, I'm losing it already here.
Cutscene initiated!
Come on now, get on up.
The fuck away from
me! Let her go.
Welcome to the game, little girl.
You're recruiting kind of young, aren't you?
She's not one of mine.
Oh, shit. What happened?
Don't worry, this is fixable. I got his help. But I can't come with you.
So is this little brat anyway?
Well, then I'm staying.
Ellie, we won't get another shot at this.
Hey, we're smuggling her?
There's a crew of Fireflies that'll meet you at the Capitol building.
That's not exactly close.
You're capable. You hand her off, come back, the weapons are yours. Double what Robert sold me.
Speaking of which, where are they?
Back in our camp.
We were going to see them, right? The weapons?
We're not smuggling shit until I see them.
We're smuggling shit now?
You'll follow me. You can verify the weapons, I can get patched up.
First it was excrement, now it's...
But she's not crossing to that part of town. I want Joel to watch over her.
Whoa, I don't think that's the best idea.
Ellie! Him?
How do you know them?
I was close with his brother Tommy. Said if I was ever in a jam, I could rely on him.
So Tommy's still alive?
Is that before or after he left your little militia group?
Good.
He left you too.
After we saw him, he was defending our honor in the
prologue. He was a good man.
Was?
I could just
take her to the North Tunnel and wait for me there.
Jesus Christ.
It's just cargo, Joel.
No more talking. You'll be fine. Now go with him.
I
don't think it's a good idea.
And you, stay close. Let's go.
And the plot thickens.
Ah, trios. Still a trio.
We dropped a member and gained a little girl named Ellie. Hey, what's up? How are you? Welcome to the team here. You're on the cover of the video game, so I'm guessing you're going to be around for a while, so. My name's Joel. I'm a 54-year-old from Texas, and, my daughter died in my arms about 20 years ago, and that was awfully traumatic, and you remind me of her. Let's not talk about it ever.
Same thing's going to happen to us if we don't get off the street.
You're the pro. I'm just following you.
Yeah. Don't forget it. Let's take a look at that pendant we just picked up. Congratulations, Hotshot. You found yourself another Firefly pendant, number 3 of 30. Philip Liu, 00105. Wow, look at that. It is in terrible condition. You bring it over to Rick Harrison in Vegas, he might give you a couple of bucks for it. For this Firefly pendant update, I am Howard Cosell of ABC Sports. Thanks, Howard. You are welcome. I can't get into this little cafe. It's worth mentioning at this juncture that, this does not really look like Boston. It kind of just looks like old Brick City. And in that last cutscene, they mentioned you have to get her to the Capitol building. Yeah, I lived in Boston for 5 years. We never called it that. It's the State House. We've always called it that since the fucking thing was built like 300 years ago. So...
down here.
You gotta get your stuff together, cause this game got it all wrong. This is not
keep up.
Very Attention. Similar to what it would really be like.
Harboring or aiding wanted criminals is punishable by death. Do not place yourself at risk. Report any suspicious activity.
I ain't reporting nothing, alright? And you know why? Cause I ain't afraid of no ghosts. Bustin' makes me feel good.
Where are we going?
Let's not forget
Up
that.
Up there. That'll get us to the North Tunnel.
How are we supposed to reach that?
Just give me a minute.
I'm gonna drag this giant dumpster over there. Okay. Again. Gotta deduct a point. Let's just say we start at 1,000. I'm deducting 1 point off of 1,000 for not being realistic to Boston. And I'm deducting another point for Joel being able to move this dumpster around like it's a balloon. Alright, it would not happen that easily. Those things weigh several hundred pounds, if not a full half ton. And he moved that thing around like it was his job.
Oh, you use the smuggle things?
Yep.
Like little girls.
Are you things?
Sometimes.
You ever smuggled before?
No, that's a first.
Stop asking questions.
What's the deal with you and Marlene anyways?
I don't know. She's my friend, I guess.
Your friend, huh? You're friends with the leader of the Fireflies. What are you, like, 12?
She knew my mom, and she's been looking after me. And I'm 14, not that that has anything to do with anything.
Same age as my dead daughter.
Where are your parents?
Where are anyone's parents? They've been gone a long, long time.
So instead of just staying in school, you decide to run off and join the Fireflies, is that it?
Look, I'm not supposed to tell you why you're smuggling me, if that's what you're getting at.
You don't know the best thing about my job. I don't gotta know why. To be honest with you, I give two shits what you're up to.
Well, great.
Good.
Because I have three shits. Maybe we should barter later. You can give me two shits, and I'll give you back the value of three. I've always been a huge fan of that saying that, hey, it's the clock tower over there. That's cool, I've been up that building before. You can actually go up for free, 2 hours every Sunday. They open up to the public, which is pretty nice. Or at least they used to. I've always been fond of that phrasing, the two shits thing, but... Never quite understood the etymology of the phrase. So, I'm gonna take a nap. I don't know, play with your dolls or something. Go have a period, I don't know, you little girl.
What are you doing?
Killing time.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
I just told you.
I am sure you will figure that out.
Your watch is broken.
Ooh. Stings a little bit. Graphics are incredible.
You mumble in your sleep.
Yeah, well, you mumble when you talk.
I hate bad dreams.
Which is to say you talk a lot. Be quiet.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I've never been this close to the outside.
About to get a whole lot closer, little girl.
Look how dark it is. Can't be any worse out there. Can it?
Oh, trust me.
Do the Fireflies want with you?
Hey. Sorry it took so long. Soldiers fucking everywhere.
How's Merlene?
Dead.
She'll make it.
Oh, sorry. Jump the gun on that.
I saw the merchandise. It's a lot. Wanna do this?
Yeah.
Let's go.
All right, now we're three people heavy again. We've got the cargo, and it is time to begin Chapter 3, The Outskirts. Optional conversation. Engage!
I think it's a bit strange that they're having us do their smuggling.
Marlene wanted to do it herself. We weren't their first choice, or the second for that matter. She's lost a lot of men. Beggars can't be choosers.
I just hope there's someone alive to pay us.
Someone will be around.
And if not, we'll murder everybody.
I found an artifact here. Yeah. Tess's list about stuff. Let's read it.
Come on.
It's a laundry list of shit. Next time she goes to Star Market, which is a regional grocery store in Massachusetts.
I wanted to read the very bottom of this. What is this? Can you believe he found this? Way to go, Bill. This one's ours, Joel. Joel, don't forget, all of these bottles need to be delivered ASAP to Donovan in the West End District. I know what you're thinking. Weak as shit delivery, Bill promised he'd do better next shipment. I don't particularly care to see what all is on the list, but the side notes, the little inside the margins things, it tells part of the story. This Bill character, we've heard a little bit about him before. He seems to be a friend, an acquirer of things. We were able to get all those pills, morphines, and weapons and stuff from Bill, so hopefully we'll meet up with him later and see what he's all about. What's this? It's a generating device. I'll just have to generate some power using brute force. And there we go. We ready to go, kids? All right, saddle up.
Who's waiting for us at the drop-off?
She said there's some Fireflies that have traveled all the way from another city. Girl must be important. What is the deal with you? You some bigwig's daughter or something?
Something like that.
No, no, we tried talking about it, but...
How long is this all gonna take?
Ended up talking about shit for a while.
If everything goes as planned, we should get you to them in a few hours.
Another artifact!
Once we get out there, I need you to follow our lead and stay close.
Yeah, of course.
Let's take a look at the patrol map. Ooh, look at this. So we have hostile camp, West Patrol, safe now. Save us route to Checkpoint Charlie. Checkpoint, I thought we were in Boston. Now we're in Soviet-controlled Berlin. Super. Just super. This game took a turn for the weird awfully quick. This isn't creepy at all. I hope we just don't run into any infected humans down here. All right, let's rock and roll, guys. Yep. Coast is clear. I don't know, maybe. I just like to say that.
There's a patrol up ahead.
Does that patrol map we picked up actually translate to help, or is it just
good.
Like...
Come on up.
Just like a fun collectible. Because there's no way to, like, use the map in a real-world sense. Because I don't know where we are on the map, so it's basically useless. Ta-da! We're outside in the fresh, infected air. Unfortunately for now, for me, that does it for this episode of Game Time. But stay tuned for the next episode of The Last of Us Let's Play, where we find out a huge secret about Ellie and why she's so precious after all. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.